Welcome to the Drew Rice Show, brought to you by Neighborhood Ford. For my neighborhood, yours, Neighborhood Ford in Irwin. I'm Marky Bilson. Unicoi County is 7-1 and going for their first 8-victory season tonight at West Green. First 8-victory season since 1989. Last year, however, West Green did defeat Unicoi County, prevented you guys from having a winning record. Is this a revenge game?
Well, I don't know if it's a revenge game. You know, every year you got different kids, and they've got a different team. They've got a different team. But you know, that's certainly something we've reminded our guys of, you know, a few times this week. You know, last year, like you said, kept us from the winning season, kept us from a home playoff. You know, I think these guys won a home playoff, you know, now that we've got the winning season part down. You know, I think that's a you know, a big deal, and it should be. And these, especially these seniors, you know, we've talked about them, you know, putting themselves in an opportunity to have the opportunity to play here another game. You know, a lot of them have played here, you know, 4 years with us, or, you know, even going back through middle school, you know, a lot of them played here their whole lives. So, you know, this place is special to them, and, you know, I think that's important to them.
Well, now, one thing about being kind of special, I know last year Julian Lane was special for West Green against Unicoi County, and now he's on ETSU. We've talked a little bit about Brett Struthers' college prospects. Any chance that he could be playing at ETSU next year with Lane?
I think that's a possibility. You know, the recruiting is kind of, I know we spoke about this last week some, it's kind of heating up a little bit, actually. We've been in contact this week, and so has Brett, with places, ETSU and Tennessee Tech, and Carson Newman, Austin Peay, a couple others. So, you know, Brett's done everything that he's supposed to do up to this point. You know, he's taken care of his work at school, and, you know, he's had a great senior season. You know, so that's a kid we're really rooting for, and it's going to be exciting to see what kind of shakes out there.
Let's look back to last week's victory against Unica, 42-0. And I noticed that the design of the offense was to go a little away from, or actually a lot away from Cody Liz, and more towards the quarterback, Brock Thompson, who responded with 4 touchdown passes. I'm wondering, was that by design? Because, let's face it, Unica is a 1-5, 1-8 team. It's an undermanned team. Was that design, hey, let's use this as a tune-up and see what we can do with the passing game? Was that the strategy?
Well, you know, we knew all year long, and, you know, even through the summer, you know, that we had a, you know, a very good quarterback, and Box had a great year. But, you know, we just had so much success running the ball that we haven't had to throw, you know, at least very much. So we just, you know, we made it a focus early to try to get him going and work on some passing things and some concepts that we, you know, want to get implemented. And, you know, I think people are probably going to rest the way, going to really try to stop our run and stop Cody. So we just, you know, took it as an opportunity to, you know, try to keep our passing game, you know, on point and where it needs to be. So I thought Brock played great and, you know, made great decisions. And, you know, he's you know, everything gets kind of lost in, you know, Cody's success and Brent's success and Noah and everything else, and rightfully so. But, you know, Brock's a really special talent, you know, to be a sophomore. And I guess he's already won 12 games, not even through his sophomore year, as a starting quarterback, which is tremendous. So he's, you know, he's probably going to have a chance to, you know, maybe be the winningest player to ever play here. You know, when you consider how much he played as a freshman, you know, certainly being the starting quarterback. So, you know, he's a special talent, and he's a great kid. And, you know, so we just, like I said, we just want an opportunity to keep our, you know, offense as balanced as possible. Because, you know, as it gets late in the year and, you know, playoffs and whatever else, you just never know. So we're just going to try to keep everything as ready as possible.
Okay, but let me ask this about Thompson. I have noticed, especially on some interceptions, that there tends to be some lollipop in his arm. Now, I remember someone who doesn't have a strong arm, you know, they have to go lollipop. In other words, a long looping throw, if people aren't familiar with the term. And sometimes I've seen that. Against Unica, his passes were more straight down the middle, that sort of thing. How do you prevent the lollipop and go more to those dart-like throws?
Yeah, you know, a lot of times what you know, early on in the year, what was happening with Moses is he was getting into his second and third, you know, progressions on his reads and then just getting it out of his hand later. And, you know, that was kind of a product of that. But, you know, and the thing about it, we've still got to remember, and that was kind of what I was getting at earlier, he's still 15 years old. You know, a lot of these high school quarterbacks you see are 17, 18 years old, and they're, you know, truly young men, you know. So I think he's only going to get bigger and better and stronger and everything else. But, you know, his decision-making and his poise, though, for his age, to me, is just, he's kind of beyond his years.
It's time to sell a car, Neighborhood Ford. Hear from them here on 1420 NBC Sports Radio, Tri-Cities, WEMB Irwin. Welcome back to the Drew Rice Show. I'm Marky Bilson, West Green. They are 2-5. They're not as strong as last year. I think I can safely say that. I'll say it. You don't have to. But what scares you about West Green?
Well, you know, Coach Case does a great job down there, and like you said, they beat us last year, so they're certainly capable. And you know, they've got some kids that are talented. The Clowers kid, number two for him. You know, he was a preseason All-State kid, so you know, he's a good ball player, and their quarterback does a good job, and he's a threat. You know, running the ball and throwing it too. So, but they've got some athletes, but you know, we feel like we've got a good game playing together, and we've had a good week of practice, so you know, hopefully it'll go well for us.
Yeah, but the season finale against Johnson County, that's going to be for the 1-3-A title. I did the stats. I believe that even if catastrophe happened, you're in the playoffs. So how do you prevent from looking ahead for the game that everyone around here has been waiting for?
Well, you know, that's one case where, you know, like we've said a little bit already, is, you know, almost maybe a loss last year is a blessing, because, you know, I think that's still on our guys' mind, and, you know, they know they're capable, and they know last year they're the reason we didn't have a home playoff game and didn't have a winning season, and, you know, so all those things, be that as it may, I think our guys, you know, have that on their mind, and these seniors and these juniors that play a whole lot, their leadership's been really strong, you know, even, you know, in weeks where we were favored, and, you know, they kind of knew that going in. I feel like we haven't had too much of a letdown, you know, even against some of the, you know, weaker teams on our schedule. So I think that's a, you know, kind of a tip of the hat to the leadership of these guys, and then especially these seniors, and how they carry themselves and how they lead this football program. So we're just going to keep leaning on that, and then hopefully, you know, it keeps going our way.
Preston Woodby suffered a concussion 2 weeks ago. What's his status?
He's good. He got cleared this week. He went through the protocol, and, you know, we got him cleared, so he's good to go. And, you know, we're going to continue to, you know, he plays on all our special teams, and he's, you know, we'll rotate in at corner, and, you know, he started a bunch of games there. So he's a good player, and he's, you know, we're certainly glad he's going to be back with us next year. But, you know, getting him back is big, and, you know, he's a great asset to this program.
Now, what else? I know some JV players are out, but what about the varsity? What's the injury report status?
We're pretty healthy, actually. This is as healthy as we've probably been, I guess. A couple of the minor stuff, like, you know, Preston's and a couple of the young guys that have gotten back, and they're healthy, and, you know, knock on wood, you know, through the course of the season, we've been lucky enough to be pretty healthy. You know, we spend a lot of time in the weight room trying to, you know, prevent injury and you know, sustain that, and you know, our guys are very willing to do what we're asked, or what we ask of them. So, you know, very, very pleased so far with that part of it.
That's the Drew Rice Show, brought to you by Neighborhood Ford. From our neighborhood to yours, Neighborhood Ford in Irwin. Back with the kickoff on 1420 NBC Sports Radio, Tri-Cities, WEMB Irwin.